Hello, children of joy. I hope that you guys are having a really good summer. Are you enjoying all this hot weather we've been having? Margaret and I have been going out and taking some walks in the evening because it's a little hot sometimes during the day to be out and about. And when we've been out in the evening, sometimes we've seen some fireflies that are really cool to watch. When I was growing up, I lived in a big old house that had a lot of fireflies out on the yard, and I would run around at night and try and capture them in a jar. And then at night, when I would climb into bed, I would listen with the windows open to the cicada bugs. And sometimes, Margaret stayed in Grandma's house where I used to sleep, sometimes the big old trees would sway back and forth, and it makes some big, scary looking, what would you call them?
Shadows.
Shadows on the wall that can kind of look a little bit creepy, can't they? So I'm curious if any of you ever get scared at night when you're laying in bed. Because I used to get scared sometimes at night when the shadows were dancing on the walls. If you do, we have the perfect story for you today. It is called Good Night Fireflies. And it's written by Janet L. Christensen, who is actually a South Dakota author. And so we're going to share this story with you today, and Margaret is going to help me tell it. Good Night Fireflies by Janet Christensen, illustrated by Francesca Pesky. The sun was setting when Landon's dad finished reading his favorite story. "Okay, champ, time for bed," Landon's dad said. Landon's tummy did a somersault.
"Can we please read another story? Please, please, please?"
he begged. "Sorry, son, it's time to go upstairs."
"But I forgot to brush my teeth,"
Landon said. "You brushed your teeth 5 minutes ago." Up, up, up. Landon's dad climbed the stairs with Landon trailing behind. When they got to his bedroom door, Landon's tummy did another somersault.
"Can I have another glass of water?"
Landon asked. His dad shook his head. Landon looked around his room, but he didn't see any spookies or creepies tonight. He got into bed and his dad pulled the covers up over his lap. "Let's pray," his dad said. Landon folded his hands, closed his eyes, and said his goodnight prayer. His dad gave him a big hug and a kiss. "Good night, Landon." Then he turned off the light and left. Landon looked around his dark room. Shadow critters snuck out of their hiding.
"Daddy, Daddy,"
Landon yelled.
"Help me, spookies, creepies."
When Landon's dad turned on the light, the shadow critters disappeared. "What's going on?" his dad asked.
"I don't want to be alone,"
Landon said. "You know, champ," his dad said, "you are never alone. God is always with you."
"But I don't see him,"
Landon said. Landon's dad nodded. "I have an idea. Let's go outside."
"But it's dark outside too,"
Landon said. "It's okay. I'll be with you." Landon's dad took his hand and led him down the stairs and out the kitchen door. The sky was filled with sparkling fireflies. Their tiny lights flashed, dancing all around the sky. Blink, blink. "When fireflies blink off, where do they go?" Landon's dad asked. "They just disappear, or are they still there even though we can't see them?" Landon shrugged. "Let's see if we can find out," his dad said. Landon's dad gave him a jar, and they tiptoed around the yard, sneaking up on the fireflies. Blink, flash. Finally, Landon caught one. The firefly lit up the jar. Then its light went out. Landon squinted his eyes and looked really closely.
"Hey, it is still there,"
he said. "God is just like these fireflies. Even though we can't see him, God is always with us. And do you know what, Landon? God is way bigger than spookies and creepies."
"Really?"
Landon asked. "Really," his dad said. "Now, let's let this little guy go." "Good night, firefly," Landon's dad said. The flashing firefly flew out of the jar into the night.
Dad, I think I'm ready to go back to my bed,
Landon said. Landon snuggled under his blanket, and his dad kissed his head one more time. Good night, champ, he said, ruffling Landon's hair. He shut off the light and closed the door. Landon looked around the room. Was that a spooky in the closet? He pulled the blanket over his head and squeezed his eyes shut.
I'm not alone. God is with me.
Then he said it again, and again, and again, until he felt brave enough to pull the blanket off his head. Landon blinked his eyes and looked around. Those weren't spookies or creepies he saw. They were only shadows. Landon settled onto his pillow.
Thank you, God, for fireflies. And thank you, God, for being with me all the time, no matter what.
The end.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we hope that you enjoyed the story, Goodnight Fireflies. And we also hope that this summer, if you are in your bedroom at night and you get a little scared by some shadows on the wall, that you remember that God is always with you, even if you can't see him, just like the fireflies blink on and off. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye-bye.